Welcome to another lesson by Maybe the Artist. Today, we are going to learn how to draw trees. First of all, I call it the equal sign tree. And you might wonder, why an equal sign? Well, when I was a little girl in math class, the teacher would say 1 + 1 = and then I would think, okay, what does it equal? Okay, 2. It was easy enough. And I always would look at those equal signs and think, that makes me think of something. And what it made me think of? A branch on a tree. Think of this. An equal sign that is long. An equal sign that is up and down, like this. The lines go parallel to each other. That means they can go on forever and ever and never touch each other. But it made me think of a branch. So, that's what we're going to do today. I'm using brown paper. I like to use different color papers instead of white. You can use white if that's all you have or if you like white. I'm also using crayons. I have an old set of crayons, as you can see. And I'm going to start with the color of the tree itself. I'm going to draw 2 lines, 1, 2. Those lines will not touch the bottom of the page because I want to leave room for ground. See, just like the equal sign. Then I'm going to do 2 more lines, like long equal signs coming out from one of the branches of the tree. Then another. And then one up in the middle. 1, 2. Don't worry about making them perfect. If for some reason they go together and they touch, that's not a problem either. Then I'm going to make little baby equal signs all over the place. 1, 2. If you make them come out straight, that's okay, but usually a tree has it coming out in an angle. And if you think that you wish you had done it at an angle, most things can get fixed. If you color that in after, no one would have seen that you had made it too straight. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. If I want, I can make it like this. It looks like the letter Y. Because when I was learning my alphabet, I was also thinking all those little letters look like things I could draw. So letter Y made me, again, think of branches. So before you know it, you have all these little branches, all these little equal signs all over the place. Then you take your color that you were drawing with and start it at the bottom, go sideways, back and forth, like a ziggy-zag shape. Ziggy-zag, ziggy-zag, up. Don't be perfect because you want some of the paper showing through. Ziggy-zag, up, 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 up. Color. Nice and fast, even. Take care, but you don't have to worry about being too precise. Precise means super duper careful. Sometimes in some artwork, you want to be super duper careful, but not all artwork. And this is one of the ones that you can be relaxed and just have a good time. There, good enough for that. I'm going to even leave that little bare spot because next color I take, black, which I use all the time. And I'm going to go draw right on the left side of the tree, not the right side. First of all, I should have done this. I'm going to draw where my son is. I'll just do a little swirly circle for a sun. Why did I do that up here? To remind myself and to use an example to you, the sun is shining this way, so anything on this side of the tree is going to be in a shadow, because that's the light source. It's funny because I can see my window over there and that light source is making a shadow the other direction. Maybe I should have put the shadow elsewhere, but I'm going to confuse everyone. I'm going to do black on the opposite side of the sun. The opposite means not the same side, but the different side. Little black lines. And then I'm going to go from that black line and make little lines, even a ziggy-zag, some shorter, some longer, right up, like this. See what I'm doing? I'm making it look like a shadow. It just makes the tree look more interesting. And then sometimes you can find out where you missed some and add it to it. Kind of doing this from it. Whoops, made a mistake. I'll just leave it there. Mistakes are fine. You make them sometimes. And when I color in the leaves after, you're probably saying, where's the mistake? I put black on the top and the sun would be shining there and it would not be a shade. But again, I'm not going to worry about that. There. Next, I'm going to do some leaves. And I'll take a green. And sometimes I do a ziggy zag shape like this. Looks like little squares. Sometimes I do twirlies like this, like messy little circles. I think I'll do messy circles today. You might come up with your own kind of idea. I'm sure you will. Because I'm left-handed, I apologize that my hand and arm block what I'm drawing at the moment. But I tried once teaching my right hand how to draw, but it just didn't work. Now, this tree in my maple leaf picture is going to be a tree in the fall. So I'm going to take different colors, like this time orange. If you live in a part of the world where the tree leaves turn color in the fall, you'll know why I'm putting orange. If you don't, now you're learning something. The leaves turn color and fall off after they make a nice decoration in the woods for a while or your yard. Anyway, it gives me an excuse to use a bunch of different colors. Notice I'm putting these little twirly thingies right on top of the tree. Now it's starting to look like a Christmas tree. Kind of funny. Yellow. I should have put yellow in there too. There. One little tip I'm going to give you. If you're using colors in a picture, before I had a yellow up there for the sun, it's good to use that color elsewhere in the picture too. Little tidbits of color. So that yellow was not going to be all by itself. Next thing I'm going to do is put some ground in. There's different ways to put ground. I'm just going to do messy-ish kind of line going here. And ziggy-zag it back a little bit. Again, leaving paper showing through. I also like to make a line starting here and pulling it up like grass growing. Maybe you forgot to mow it, or it's out in the woods. Then I take the black again, starting at the bottom of the tree, and I go ziggy-zag out a little bit. Looks like some shade coming out onto the grass. So if it was a hot day, that would be where you would lay down in the shade and read a good book. For interesting thing to put in, I like to put in a white fence. So this tree's not in the woods because you wouldn't find a white fence in the woods. I'm drawing some white posts and making them green by mistake because craypaws tend to mix together. So the green, I better draw downward, is mixing in. Then the sideway part right here, I'm going to stop at the tree so it looks like the fence goes behind the tree. One, two, one, two, one, two. And this goes off to the side. Now I'm going to take the black again. On the left side of the fence part post, I'm going to do a black. I'm going to hop over. I find it looks a little more interesting if I don't just draw a plain straight line down. And then underneath, because I'm reaching out from the side, it's getting kind of messy. You would think it'd be not so hard to draw like this in front of the camera, but it is. I like to have it in front of me. But I'm trying to keep myself out of the picture here. So the picture is the important part. So there we go. Well, you can look back and I thought a little more black there. And there you have a tree. Of course, when I step back, I see some blank spots. I should put more color in. If you had crayons, and here's an example of one done with crayons, and you draw a curvy, puffy cloud around the tree and then use the colored crayons to fill in, that's another way to do it. I did not put in a fence on this one. What I did do, though, is a border. I like borders because it makes the page show nicely when you hang it on the wall or your refrigerator after. Here's another example of a tree that Mimi has drawn in one of her books, The Adventures of Mimi the Artist. This happens to be book one, part one, the very first book of the art series that Mimi the Artist has for kids to learn about art. And this tree is very, very similar to that tree. It doesn't have any leaves though, does it? And the branches are all kind of bumpity because Little Brown Bear and Mimi the Artist are trying to break off branches of a dead tree to use it. I'm not going to give away the story, but they're taking that branch to help someone. So maybe if you buy the book, you can find out. You can go to Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com, or even to MimiTheArtist.com and find out how to buy the book. So that's it for today's lesson, how to draw a tree, and I will soon have other lessons. Thank you for joining. Bye.